and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be eating food from my freezer. At the minute, I'm trying to clear out my freezer because I want to make more space, and there's things that I've just had in there for ages. So my mission this week is to eat things out of my freezer, not for breakfast, lunch or dinner, but just try and think about what's in there a bit more. So then I thought, why don't I just make a video out of it and eat food from my freezer for the whole day. So here I am. Let's just get on with the video. I hope you guys enjoy this one. If you do, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're new here. Let's see what I had for breakfast. It's time for breakfast and I need to go and look in my freezer. I haven't actually planned out or worked out what I'm gonna eat today. I mean, I kind of know what's in my freezer and I kind of don't. Obviously the things that I see at the top each time I open it stick out in my mind. It's actually not as full as I thought, but when I keep buying stuff and I have to move things around, that really annoys me. When you're like trying to find space for stuff. So yeah, also I have a whole bag of bagels in there, which I mentioned in another video, that's really annoying that I've put them in there whole. But yeah, let's have a look. Here's the top drawer. Here's the big bag of bagels. And then we've got some normal bread and cinnamon and raisin toast. Lots in there. And this one is just made up of frozen fruits. So, oh, and some little mains. Also, I think I need to de-ice my freezer, but yeah, that's for another day. I have got one hash brown left, so I'm gonna use this. It's covered in ice, so I hope that's okay. These, which I haven't even tried yet, so I thought it would be good to try together. I bought these a couple weeks ago now, and they are the jumbo chip shop sausages. So I'm gonna have like a mini fry up. I'm gonna use a slice of this bread, and then, even though it's not in the freezer, I still need to use these up. I've got how many eggs in here? 4 eggs, and they go out of date next week. Off to a good start, I'd say. Even though I've got to put the whole box back in the freezer, so it kind of feels like it's not really going to get rid of much space. But you know, we're making progress. This looks like such a measly breakfast now, but I'm sure it'll be lovely. I had to cut this in half because it literally didn't fit in my air fryer. No, what happened to my egg? It's just gone hard in the middle. Main thing I want to try is the sausage, because obviously everything else I have tried before. That is exactly how I like my sausage to taste. Not a herb inside. Let me try it without the ketchup. And then I just dipped it straight, but what is my problem? Let's try again. I mean, you can't go wrong. Hash brown in the air fryer is the best. Time for me to pick something for lunch. I do have these bacon and cheese turnover, kind of like a croissant thing that I got from M&S, but I think yees would be sick of the sight of me eating another version of essentially a ham and cheese croissant. So I'm gonna give that a miss. So yeah, we've got some jacket potatoes, but I don't really feel like I need to get rid of these. Got some fish burgers hidden back here. Oh, I've actually got so much, it's stressing me out. Got some more sausages in there. Got some halloumi nuggets. Oh, maybe I'll have some of them. Some things need to be defrosted first, so I'm gonna have to give them a miss. And then here's just a load of potatoes. Maybe I'll, no, we'll come back to them, come back to them. Okay, let me decide. Also, I thought I'd run out of croissants, but I don't. I've still got one left. I'm about to have the most random combination, but I don't even have any like wraps or anything in. There is some wraps in the freezer, but it says consume within 3 months of freezing, and they've probably been freezed for about a year. So things like that I just need to get rid of now because they haven't been used. But I do have these tandoori skewers. The bag is filled with ice. Like, is that normal? And then to go with it, I'm going to use the rest of these halloumi nugs. Weird combo, but who cares, you know? You've got to do what you got to do to clear out the cupboards or the freezer or whatever. These are from Iceland, by the way. It's time for lunch, and this is my lunch. This is not a good vibe. But when I thought about what I was going to have... Oh, a bit high there. When I thought about what I was going to have for dinner, I was like, that'll be too much the same as what I'll have for lunch. So to try and make it different, that's why I've gone for the halloumi. But then to be fair, if you go to like a restaurant, you can get those deals that are like 3 small plates for £12 at Wetherspoons. And this is basically what I'm doing here, right? I've got halloumi and chicken.
chicken skewers. When these halloumi nuggets were cooking in the air fryer, they were like mash and they were disintegrating. They seem to have hardened up a bit now, but I seem to remember when I had these before, they weren't that great. I think they're from Aldi. They're definitely not as soggy as they was when they was in the air fryer. They've definitely hardened up now. I've also got some mango chutney on my plate to have with my tandoori chicken and a bit of mayo. I do promise you guys that dinner will be a bit better. I'm also going to have something sweet after this. I feel like it's needed. I can't remember if I've said this on the channel or not before, but my boyfriend kind of left my freezer a bit open before and it proper iced over. I think I didn't proper de-ice it after that, so I do think I need to do that properly one day. But things like that is just such a mission, isn't it? Who has got time to de-ice their freezer? That's a Sunday job, that is. If I've ever seen one. These halloumi nuggets are actually a lot better than I remember. Maybe I didn't air fry them last time, who knows. Also, you guys would be really proud of me. I've done 2 workouts in the last 2 days. I'm starting to get back on my workout era because I still haven't gone back to the gym. So it's been over a year now and I'm like, this is not okay for me. And I love the feeling that you feel after you've actually worked out. It's just making myself do it. And I feel like once you've done the first one, or the first week of workouts, it's fine. It's just getting that first one out of the way. Like, why is it such a mental battle? I know there's obviously a lot of people that go gym every day for hours on end, and to them they're probably like, what? But to the average person who doesn't work out all the time, I don't know what it is. There's just something about it. But now I'm like, right, you got this. Next step is to return to the gym. Okay, so I would ask for advice on how to just get over the fear, but I know it is literally just go there. Anyway, I'm going to finish this and then I'll see you guys for an afternoon snack. I'm back in the kitchen and I'm going to make myself a little yogurt bowl. I'm going to use a yogurt which isn't from the freezer and mix it with some frozen raspberries, add some frozen raspberries on top, maybe something else, I don't know. I'm really craving something sweet now. Right, I've got my frozen fruit in. I'm going to add this yogurt, blend it together, and then some more frozen and raspberries on top. Love this color, but you can't really see how pink it is. Is that better? The final product, you're probably bored of seeing me eat this in some form in my last few videos, but I can't help it. I'm trying to catch this on camera, but the weirdest thing is happening to me today. I've got this throbbing in my chin, so I filmed it because it feels like a full-on twitch, like a proper like feels like a muscle is moving. I filmed it and literally it's going like this. Like, you can see this lump moving. It's freaking me out. Like, I know you get like a twitch in your eye, but I've never had it like just randomly in my chin before. I added the tiniest bit of water because it wasn't blending and it's just gone too liquidy, which is weird because obviously the yogurt isn't even that liquidy and I've added loads of fruit. And when I say a splash, I mean it. Also, apologies now, I'm not in the most talkative mood today. That time of the month is approaching and we all know the approaching of your period is a lot worse than the actual period. I mean, it is for me. But yeah, you know when you're just like, I can't be bothered to talk to anyone. I can't be bothered to even talk to myself. You know when your brain's at zero capacity? That's what it feels like. Also, I finally started reading Verity and I'm more than halfway through. I'm not hooked, I must say. I've taken like a day break between reading and I only read like 1 or 2 chapters at a time. I can't see how the story is going to twist. It's already quite dark. Well, I think I know what happens. I've kind of gathered what happens. But yeah, I'm not gripped because I feel like I already know the outcome. Oh, I don't want to tell you guys. Obviously, it's not a spoiler. I haven't even finished reading it. This is just my guess. So my guess is, if you guys have read the book, don't tell me if I'm right or wrong, by the way. I'll revert once I've finished it. But my bet is the mother killed the 2 daughters and then her cover writer falls in love with the lady's husband. Now, if you haven't read it, then you'll have no idea what I'm talking about. If you like the sound of my made up story that hasn't happened yet, then check the book out. Anyway, I'm gonna finish eating this and then I need to get editing. So I will see you guys now for dinner. It's time for me to make dinner and I've just got a few more bits out of the freezer. I still feel like I haven't really made a dent. Maybe I should have done this as a week long one, but anyway, I have these, which I recently tried in an M&S video, and this was amazing, but it was mainly because of the sauce. I mean, the chicken was still good, but the sauce was the best part. But yeah, so I had some left over, so I'm gonna have some of these chicken pieces. A day full of beige food, isn't it, really? And then these, which I bought a while ago, but haven't even used them. Salt and pepper style chips. You get sachets in it, it says. These are new as well. I picked these up in Iceland. Oh, I can put these on the chicken as well. Yeah, it literally just says, season in a bowl, place in the oven. So I'm gonna put a bit on them. Let's hope they're about the same time in the oven. Probably are not. They're about. But we all know they lie on chips. Like they always say, like, cook for 20 minutes. No, they always need 30. They always need 10 more than what they say because I like a crispy chip.
Gotta love a freezer tea. This is some Korean barbecue sauce that's really good. I think it's supposed to be like a marinade, but I'm using it to dip my shit in.
I've just started watching Sophia and Chintzia's Mykonos vlog. It gets me so excited. I'm not going away until August. Now I feel like I wish I'd booked a holiday earlier in the year. I'm going away 3 times. 1 time is a surprise from my boyfriend, so I don't know, but I probably will vlog that. Marbella, I don't know if I will vlog Marbella. Probably will. When you go to places like that, it's really hard to film because you just get copyrighted. And because it's more like we're going to be partying, all it is like me saying I'm hungover and then not really filming much. So maybe I will, maybe I won't, who knows. We're going to COS at the end of September, which is all inclusive, and I'll definitely vlog that. Although we are going for 10 days, so I probably won't vlog every day, I don't know. But holiday vlogs are my fave, and I hope you guys have watched my holiday vlogs, because I've got a few on my channel. I've got a Croatia one, a Krakow one, a Crete one. I think that's it. These chips are really nice. Look at how long this is. This must have come from a jacket potato. Hope these are just as good. That is good, especially with the seasoning that come with it. Mmm, that is bloody lovely. I was half tempted to try the M&S prawns again, but this time try them in the oven. But I just thought, I don't wanna put myself through it. It's the fishiness that got me. Oh yeah, also, haven't given you guys who listen to my podcast an update on our podcast. Last time me and Jade recorded an episode, I can't remember now, I think it was April, and then we needed to record one. We couldn't get a date in the diary for the next week. Then Jade went on holiday, and then we thought, right, we'll just come back as a new series. But then we haven't even seen each other since then. Every time we're like, oh, can you do this date? Nope. Can you do this date? Nope. And we just keep missing each other. And then Jade wanted to take a break because she had other stuff going on. Yeah, we've kind of gone on an unintentional break. And then I forgot that I haven't even mentioned anything. And then we was like, oh, next time we see each other, we'll do a post and put it on our podcast Instagram. And then we didn't do it. And then I've just remembered now that we didn't do it. Hold tight. We will keep you updated when we've actually updated ourselves. But the thing is, we don't want our whole friendship to be the podcast. You know, we have to see each other. She leads a busy life. Not so much me. When people want to see me during the week, I'm like, I'm filming on that day, so I can't really see you until I finish filming. Oh God. Anyway, that is it. But I am going to put you guys in a time lapse, and I'm going to finish this dinner, which I've only really got my chips left anyway. This is up close and personal. Time for dessert, and I have got myself in my little glass dish, my little goo pot. I think I've left this too long. I thought I put a timer on my phone, and then I thought it feels a bit long, and then I looked and there was no timer. But I have a pistachio little moon, and these are amazing. You're supposed to leave them out for 5 minutes. I always leave them for 10 anyway, but I think I've really over squished this. Squished it. The more defrosted these are, the better they are, in my opinion. I like them to be a bit melted. I know some people are funny with ice cream, but I like my ice cream more melted. And the pistachio one is definitely my favourite. Oh, that gets a 10 out of 10 from me. Rating it like it's the first time I've tried it. But if you haven't tried and you like pistachio ice cream, I recommend you try the Little Moons one. Anyway, I'm going to wrap the video up here. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're new here. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in my next one.